Worship the Lord. Worship Him. Praise God forever. Praise God forever. Praise God forever. Praise God forever. Today, I know many will be surprised to say, Mama Eunice is coming out today, Saturday, 4th of April 2020. Yes, I'm coming out today to encourage someone. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I'm coming out today to encourage someone. I'm coming out today to bless someone. Hallelujah. Glory be to God Almighty. Amen, 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 amen. Amen, amen, amen. Once again, we are from Jesus Power Assembly of All Nations, 9000 Ghent number 15, then the Monday 16th week. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Yes, everybody staying home for now. Glory be to God. We are staying home, but we are still in the presence of the Almighty God 24 hours in a day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are staying home, but still in His presence. Glory be to God. So if you are staying home like we are doing, you know, we are staying home, we are not going anywhere, you know, just enjoying the presence of God at home. If you are also staying home, which I know that you do, you are staying home, you are home now, praise God. Use this opportunity to worship the Lord, to praise Him, and the blessing, for there is none like Him. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So it is wonderful. It's really something that someone was telling me, say, Mama, if anybody tells me that a time like this will come, whereby the whole wide world, hallelujah, you know, we experience such a thing. This is not something that you say some countries are experiencing, some countries are not. This is something that is the whole wide world, you know, is a country. Praise the Lord. I say praise the Lord. But for we children of God, like I read last week, Isaiah 26 verse 20, this period we are right now, the Almighty God already knows it. He knows it from the beginning of the creation of the world. God Almighty know it, Jesus know it, Holy Spirit know it, the host of heaven knows. This time that we are experiencing now, what is going on right now, God already knows it, is aware of it. That was why Isaiah 26 verse 20, where I read last week, you know, comes into existence. We all see what God said to us, you know, that when a time like this comes, that we should stay indoors, we should close our doors until the plague is over. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So that is exactly what we are doing. What is happening right now is not new to to believers. It's not new to we Christians. It's not a new thing. When you study Isaiah chapter 26 verse 20, you will see that it's not a new thing. God is aware of it. God already knows it. That's why he provided the solution. He said when it is happening, go and read it again. Peradventure you didn't listen to my last week a message. Go get back to it again. Just tap Pastor Unisage. Hallelujah. Just tap Pastor Unisage. You will get all our messages there. You will hear the message well. So today, I'm just here to tell us as we are home. Praise the Lord. Many people are using this opportunity to do things that are not really godly, to do things that are not pleasant to God. Many people are using this time, this opportunity to be depressive. Some are thinking of all kinds of negative things, but I'm here to tell you once again. I'm here to tell you once again that please, people of God, be happy. Be happy. Praise God. Be happy. Be happy. This is the time of happiness. Someone might be asking, what is this woman talking about? You know, when everywhere is on a standstill, lockdown, you are telling us to be happy. Yes. Yes. Praise the Lord. Go and read Isaiah 26 verse 20. You will see that this time we are now, you need to be happy because God knows it already. He's aware of it. Hallelujah. Praise God forever. Let's go to the book of Psalm 100. Let's see what the Bible says. It says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all you lands, all you lands. It didn't say the people. It said all you land. It means that this time we are now, every country should make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Praise the Lord. And especially believers, you know. And my message this time is not only to believers. It's to believers and unbelievers, those who believe in God and those who does not believe in God, because God has proven that he is God. Hallelujah. You see, many doctors all over the world, they are confused. You know, many are people, you know, they are confused. People that are in high rank, they are confused. Hallelujah. This is the time to turn to God. This is the time to return to God. The Bible says, when you return to God, God also will return back to you. So this is the time, you know, that everyone have to search their heart. Everyone have to search, you know, to search who you really, who are you in Christ. This is the time to question your walk with God. This is the time to give your life properly to Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. If a sickness, a disease, a virus, you know, called coronavirus, can keep everyone on a lockdown, can keep a whole country, the whole world on a standstill, no movement, nothing. Don't you know that God is communicating something to us? Now, God has given all doctors all over the world, you know, chances to prove, you know, their skills. God has given intelligent people now, you know, all the opportunity to prove, you know, their skills. Praise God. You can see doctors are doing their best. Doctors all over the world, they are doing their best. People are intelligent, giving, you know, giving all kind of giving all kind of, you know, words, or helping, you know, bringing all kind of ideas, like covering your nose, like covering your ears, like covering your hands, like covering your, you know, covering your head, covering your everything, all what is coverable. They are giving ideas. These are all good ideas, you know, but upon that, you see how people are dying. You see how people are dying, like just, even animals doesn't die like that. Hallelujah. So God, in his infinite mercy and wisdom, is giving everyone opportunity to turn to him. Praise the Lord. He's giving everyone opportunity to turn to him. So this is the time that we question our walk with God. This is the time that we ask, am I really a child of God? Am I really born again, Holy Ghost filled? Am I really swimming in the blood of Jesus Christ? Am I really a born again child of God? This is the time to put yourself in order. And this is the time, you know, to get back to him in a full measure. Hallelujah. Look at what the Bible says. in Psalm 100 verse 1. He said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, O you land. So you see that come rain, come shine, come diseases, come health, come any, whatever, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Let nothing keep you or stop you from making a joyful noise unto the Lord. Wherever you are, in your home, I always, when I speak to people on phone, when I counsel people, when I'm talking with people on phone, the first thing I say to them, please let your worship and your praise, you know, let it be intact. Let it not be shaken. Let your praise and worship be intact. This is the time to praise the Lord. This is the time to worship the Lord. You know what? Nobody have excuse now not to worship the Lord. Because in internet, you just put on, like you see just now, begin with the more. You just to put, before you have to buy the DVD, you have to buy the CD. This time, you don't need to buy it. Just go on internet, you just write the more. You know, you write your favorite worship artist or actresses or whatever. You just write it, you know, you tap it and it's out. Then you begin to, you know, worship the Lord with your favorite, you know. And not only always worship with them, you have your own worship time as well. That you are in your closet, that you are in your bedroom, that you are in your altar, your place where you pray, you worship God from your spirit. You know, praise the Lord. So this is the time, in other words, this is the time to be busy. Busy spiritually. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God, praise God, praise God. This is the time to be busy. This is the time to be busy. Hallelujah. Praise God forevermore. I say hallelujah. Verse 1, Psalm 100 verse 1. He said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all you lands. Verse 2, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. You see, you are indoor right now, not to be depressive, not to be thinking, not to be thinking about, you know, this, that. God is giving you chance now, you know, to reconcile properly with him. Do you know that when you are too busy, you know, always doing that, you may not even, you know, be conscious when you are going astray, when you are going out of his presence. So you use this time now that, you know, you are being asked to stay indoor. You use this time now, you know, to bring the presence of God to your home, to bring the presence of God, you know, into the lives of your children, your husband, your wife, you know, your family, in your entire home. Praise God forever. Hallelujah. Someone was telling me, you know, among my children, friends, was saying, Mama, you know what? You know, anytime I visit you, anytime, you know, I come to your home, I feel more peace. I feel more, you know, I feel more comfortable. Hallelujah. I don't know why. I said, you know what? My daughter, you know what? It's one of my children. It's a friend to one of my children. Hallelujah. So sometimes, you know, they can just come over to come and, you know, stay with their friends and, you know, have good time. And, then, you know, we hear the word of God together. We praise together. We sing together. Praise God forever. You know. Was telling me, say, Mama, I say, each time I come to your house, you know, the presence, what I feel is wonderful. I feel peace. I feel, you know, but the moment I leave, you know, I begin to feel heavy again. The moment I leave, I don't just feel heavy immediately. After 2 days, you know, I begin to feel, you know, but the moment I get to your house to come and visit you people, I feel, you know, praise God. I say, praise God, you know. You always come to see my children, you know. So, what is in your home? Let the presence of God be in your home, that even when somebody comes to visit you, he will feel the presence of God. He will feel, you know, you don't say it to somebody. You will feel it. Hallelujah. It will feel the power. It will feel the presence. The presence of God will be all over. Hallelujah. Praise God. Look at what the Bible says here. He said, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Verse 3, he said, know you that the Lord, he is God. It is he that had made us. Praise God. Praise God. Let this time, use this time to realize that it's God that made you. Forget about what is happening. Use this time as a very wonderful time that you are home. You know, use it to bring the presence of God into your family, into your home, into your children's life, into your husband's life, into your own life. Praise God. Into your family, any family that is living with you, use this time to bring the presence of God. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. Always be in the spirit so that the presence of God will be heavy in your home. The presence of God will be heavy in your home. Use this time to reconcile your home back to God. Use this time to bring back, you know, your entire home, you know, to God. Hallelujah. You will never regret it. You will live to enjoy it all the days of your life. Even when everything is now becoming normal again, people is going to work, students going back to school, business people going back to their business places, and all this stuff. When it begins to happen, you will see that the presence of God will stay permanently in your home. So use this time to praise and worship and pray and do all kinds of spiritual warfare in your home. Like the Bible says in Psalm 100 from verses 1 to 5. Praise God. Verse 4 right now. He said, enter into his gate with thanksgiving and into his court with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. Be thankful to God. Listen, listen. If you have life, be thankful to God. If you are breathing today, be thankful to God. If you are alive today, it is because of if you are alive today, there is a reason for that. Praise the Lord. I say praise the Lord. If you are alive today, there is a reason why you are alive today. So use every day of your life to praise the Lord. Use every day of your life to praise the Lord. Use every day of your life to worship and do all kind of praise unto the Lord. Hallelujah. For he is worthy of our praise. He is a glorious and a wonderful Father. He is an awesome God. He's wonderful. Hallelujah. Praise God forever. Praise God forever. He said, now, verse 5. He said, for the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. The truth of God, you know, it stands forever. It stands forever. Jesus is love. Jesus is love. And he's the reason why we are living. Listen, very soon we'll be experiencing, you know, entering into Easter. Hallelujah. The death, the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So I want you, you know, to start, you know, to start praying, praising, worshiping. Hallelujah. Let the power of resurrection, that same spirit that raised up Christ from the dead, let that same spirit begin to move in your home now. Anything that is dead in your home before, now that you are now home, you are not going to work, you're not going to school, you're not going to your business places, you're not going to church, you know, you are now home. You are not even going out to have a walk. You are now home. So use that power, use that strength, use the opportunity, you know, to invite the power, that same spirit that raised up Christ from the dead. Let that same spirit begin to fill your home from this moment, so that you know you will be you will do wonders and you will do exploits. Praise the Lord. I say praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want to wish everybody this a wonderful Easter that we're about to enter right now. We don't know how it's really going to be. Maybe everything will be okay before then. We are all praying. Hallelujah. Thank God for all the pastors all over the world that has been praying. I want to really thank you all. I want to thank a lot of pastors. I cannot be mentioning names now. Praise God, because they are too numerous. They are too numerous. I want to say a very big thank you to our big daddy, Prophet TB Joshua. I want to say a very big thank you to our big daddy, Pastor Chris Oyakhilome. I want to say a very big thank you to our big daddy, Pastor Adeboye, our big daddy, G.O. Adeboye. I want to say thank you, daddy. And I want to also use this opportunity to thank another big daddy in the world. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. The general of now, Papa Oyadepo. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I want to use this opportunity to thank our another big daddy, Papa Olukoya, Papa Kumuyi, Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God, Papa Yorisha Jaffo. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ of Nazareth. If I didn't mention your name, that's what I was saying just now, I may not remember everyone's name, but I know that you all are praying. So all these are our generals, God's general. And of course, I want to use this opportunity to say big thank you also for praying in this period to our another daddy, Johnson Suleiman. I want to use this opportunity also to say a big thank you to another, there is one big man of God also, another wonderful man of God, a very serious one, Holy Ghost filled as well. It's also called Suleiman or something like that. Praise God, praise God, praise God, and above it all, hallelujah! I want to use this opportunity to say to my big and wonderful sweet husband, Pastor Eddie Sage of Jesus Power Assembly. This is a man with my own very eyes. I have seen, hallelujah, glory be to God. He just came back also from the church this morning as well. Was in church since yesterday, 10 o'clock, praying, hallelujah. Came back early this morning. I want to say a very big thank you to you, my sweet husband, the father of my children, my wonderful daddy, my in fact, before God, you are next. Hallelujah. You are my everything. You know, you taught me a lot of things. And then now, I'm really burning for Christ. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. This is a man that does not play with the things of God. He does not play with anything that has to do with God. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. I say praise the Lord. He's very careful. Hallelujah. He don't make friends because there are a lot of people who will proclaim they are servants of God in the mouth, but their heart is far from Christ. So he's a man of God that in this Europe, someone was saying to me one time, he said, I'm just too surprised that, you know, Pastor Eddie could do 40 days, you know, without food and water, 40 days. You know, I'm surprised Pastor Eddie could do 21 days, could do, you know, I am so in this Europe where there is food everywhere, everywhere, where there is food, you know, where people cannot even fast from 6 to 6, you know, you see, when God called you, the first thing he does is to equip you. You know, it's to equip you. It's not by power, it's not by might. You know, it is by the Spirit of God. When he called you into the field, the first thing he does is to equip you. So sin will never come to your mind. You know, deceit will never come to your mind. Lies will never come to your mind. You know, what will come to your mind because he called you. Because he called you. He will, you know, it's always the things of the spirits. The things of the spirit. That is the reason that there is no deliverance this servant of God, Pastor Eddie, cannot handle by the Spirit of the Almighty God. Hallelujah. Anyone that God called, he equipped. He equipped. When God equipped you, you know, you will not fall into sin. When God equipped you, you will talk right. When God equipped you, you will do the right things. Hallelujah. You will walk with the right people. If there are no right people around you, you will walk alone. Hallelujah. Be rooted and planted in Christ. Hallelujah. So I'm using this opportunity, of course, to thank every Christian all over the world. All Christians all over the world, you know, that has been praying in this period. I say, may the Almighty God bless you all. You know, may the Almighty God keep you all. May the Almighty God shine his face upon you all, because your prayers really worked. All our generals, all our daddies that I have mentioned, and the ones that I didn't remember your name, God Almighty will bless you all. Hallelujah, because your prayers really worked. Your prayer worked. The virus is dead. The virus is dead. Coronavirus is dead. Hallelujah, is dead. So what you people are just saying now is just, you know, the virus itself is dead. But what we are just seeing now is the ones that is on the, you know, that is on the people that they are treating, and they are, so, you know, it's, I don't know how I can put it across to you, but all I can tell you by the Spirit of the Almighty God, the virus itself is dead and rooted and has been sent back to where it came from. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. What an awesome God we serve. So that is why I'm really, really appreciating all the servants of God all over the world that has been praying, and of course, Christians all over the world that has been praying. That's why I really appreciate you all. I really appreciate you all, because we have seen in the realm of the spirit that virus is dead. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. Very soon, everything will come back to normal again, and everybody will begin to have their lives again. Praise the Lord forever. I want to say a very big thank you to all Christians that have been home praying and worshiping the Lord. Keep worshiping the Lord. Keep worshiping the Lord according to the book of Psalm 100 from verses 1 to 5. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Let His presence fill your home. Let His presence fill your environment. Let people feel your presence. Hallelujah. Glory be to God Almighty. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. May the Almighty God keep you all. May the Almighty God shine His face upon you. May the Almighty God elevate everyone that listen to me today in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So I'm going to pray for everyone in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I decree and I declare that the power of the Almighty God will begin to do wonders in your lives. The glory of God will never depart from your home, from your work, from your businesses, from your finance, from your children's life, from your spouse's life, from your parents, from your brothers and sisters. May the Almighty God begin to do wonders. May the Almighty God begin to lift every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. By the blood of Jesus Christ and the power of resurrection, that that same power that raised up Christ from the dead, let that power begin to move into your home right now in the name of Jesus Christ to repair any damage. Whatever has been damaged in your home spiritually, physically, and otherwise, let that same power, let that same spirit that raised up Christ from the dead begin to work wonders in your home now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I cover all your homes with the blood of Jesus Christ. I cover everything that concerns you, you that is watching me, you that is listening to me. I cover everything that concerns you with the precious blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. May the Almighty God bless you all. May the Almighty God keep you. May the Almighty God shine His face upon everyone. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. I'll still come your way tomorrow on the fifth Sunday. Today is just fourth. Hallelujah. I just want to keep somebody busy. That is why I'm here today. Praise God. Be 4th of April 2020. Hallelujah. Saturday. Normally, I don't come out on Saturday, but today I just decided to come out so we can, you know, hallelujah, praise God. So I'm coming again tomorrow, big time. You know, don't miss it. Expect my message tomorrow. It's going to be awesome tomorrow. It's going to be awesome, and you are going to be mightily blessed tomorrow, Sunday, 5th April, 2020. Shalom. Bye. God bless you. Bye-bye. Let your anointing fall. We declare your name, Lord Jesus, as the only name we say. We pray.
Declare your name, Lord Jesus. as the only name who saves.
Happy the
let your power, let your presence fill our homes. Fill everything that we do, Lord Jesus. As we worship you, hallelujah, hallelujah. As we
worship,
hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord,
praise
the Lord.
As we worship,
yes, Lord Jesus,
we lift your hands and lift your hands.
Let your power, Lord, fill everything that will lay our hands to.